That's where the body shot hit me. Yeah, that shot to the liver was, took my breath away. But I knew I was still in the fight. Hey everyone, it's Angela Lee here, the current one atomweight world champion. Today, I'm gonna be sitting down and rewatching my last fight and giving you guys some inside commentary on what happened that night. Yeah, this is exactly the game plan, to rush her, close the distance immediately, keep the pressure, put her on the cage, and here I was able to clinch her up tight. I was trying to get that right underhook, but she was defending it pretty well, so I only had a whizzer on the left side. Here we're just clinching for a little bit. I go for the headlock, but I know I don't have it, it's a bit loose, so I don't wanna risk my back taken, so I cut back pretty soon, I think, or turn here. I'm feeling pretty comfortable, even though my back's against the cage. It's just right where I wanna be. Oh, that's where the body shot hit me. Yeah, that shot to the liver was, took my breath away. But I knew I was still in the fight. Yeah, that liver shot, it hurt. It took my breath away. I was sucking wind for a good few seconds, but in my mind, you know, my reason to keep on fighting, I did not want to lose. I needed to do everything I could. It was a liver shot. It was not like I got knocked in the head and I couldn't like think. I couldn't breathe, but I could still think. Yeah, and I knew exactly what I needed to do. You know, I thank my experience for that. I was like, there's no way, I gotta keep fighting. And so I just kept trying to march forward, close the distance. And so I shot here, grabbed her leg, tried to tie her up so I could get my breath back. I just didn't want them to stop the fight early. That's why I just kept moving forward. I would manage to tie up her arm here, land some shots to the body in the head. I was just trying to secure my grip so that I could take her down to the ground. Yeah, and here we go, we're finally on the ground. Get my hook in and secure the back. So here I'm just breathing, getting my air back. I'm in a good dominant position, so I'm not rushing anything. Get the figure four lock on the body. And immediately I'm trying to improve my position to try and hunt for a submission. Just doing a good job of defending here. We knew that she would be able to defend and scramble out of positions, but we knew that she would not be able to keep up with the transitions and the amount of submissions I was throwing at her. So if she was defending one, we go to another. And if she defend that one, we go to another. I was confident that I was levels above her in this area. Yeah, I think that's definitely her trying to show that she was okay and she wasn't spooked on the ground. But just wait till the next round. I was scared because my body, I knew, was still not 100%. So I wanted to definitely close the distance early, get her down to the ground. I knew that this time she wasn't getting back up. I really love throwing knees on the ground, and I think it's a game changer for sure when people feel those knees. They don't expect that. But here I got the triangle. I was trying to go for a Kimura. The arm straightened out. The triangle wasn't completely sunken in. She was doing the right things here by standing up and trying to shuck her head out. So actually I was trying to secure it and relatch, but eventually we end up flipping and I think getting inverted. So here I'm trying to attack the arm, trying to strike. So I could feel it slipping out, so I was trying to get on top here. Try and switch to an arm bar here, and then she hopped over. So here I do a little bridge to get back to top position. I'm a very dynamic fighter and grappler, and so I love to hunt for different submissions, and I love to move from one position to another, and that kind of fluidity and aggressiveness is kind of my style. So here I got the twister position, but I knew she was gonna be tough, so I was cranking it, and it was pretty deep, it was pretty in. I didn't have the leg as secured as I would like, but it was in the hip, it was cranking her neck and spine, but I knew she was tough. So I knew I didn't want to waste any more energy, so I unlatched my leg. Here she gave me her back, and I knew I got the underhook, so I was kind of high here. I wanted to flatten her out, and was slicing the hand under the neck, doing some more damage, ground and pound, and 10 seconds left, managed to crank that neck and get the tap. There's not really any words that you're able to describe, you know, for this moment. You know, it's just amazing. This is why I do what I do. I love this feeling. Even though I was ecstatic and I was so happy, overwhelmed with emotion that I you know, I won my fight, my comeback fight, I look over to her and I know what that's like, you know, and she really gave it her all. The stakes are at the highest, and it doesn't go your way that day. She's great. I look at her and I see like a young kid. I see a lot of myself in her, and it's funny because we're just a couple years apart, but you know, she's really how I was starting out in one. And for me, so much has happened since 2015. You know, I've gone through so much in life, but now, you know, getting the win, defending my title, coming back after having a baby, for me, like, there was a lot of expectations coming into this fight, but, you know, more than anything, you know, proving to myself that I still got it and I'm better than ever. I think this is definitely my best performance to date. So here, I'm so happy, but I was looking for my baby. I was like, where's Ava? And even Chachu, he's like, where's Ava? I could picture this moment when I was training. I could picture this moment, you know, when every single day of my fight camp, and this is what I was visualizing, and to see it actually happening, you know, was, I don't know, it's very special for me.